Welcome back. After a three-year break due to COVID, it was an emotional and poignant Anzac Day ceremony at Gallipoli for the dawn service yesterday.
Europe correspondent Carrie-Anne Greenbank was there and she joins us now. Carrie-Anne, what was the feeling like?
Good morning, Carl and Ali. Well, the mood was one of personal reflection. It was a really intimate service. It was a lot smaller than normal. And there was a real focus on the friendship between Australians, New Zealanders and the Turkish. In fact, there was a lot of Turkish locals actually attending the commemorations as the local community here really welcomes Australians back with open arms. Now, people attending the service turned their attention to the past, 107 years ago when the Anzacs landed at Gallipoli, but a lot of them were also looking towards the future, considering the issue of war still raging in Ukraine.
In this modern time, with wars around us, it's again another poignant time to appreciate what we have.
You come here and you see this and learn about this. And there we have another situation occurring over there, you know. Do you think they'd learn? They don't seem to learn.
Now, organisers say there were just over 500 people in attendance at this service, but they say the aim of 2022 was re-establishing the Anzac tradition here in Gallipoli after 2 years of cancellations, and they're hoping that next year we will see bigger numbers here. Carl and Ali?
How was it for you personally to be there?
Yeah, it was really beautiful. It was a really touching ceremony. And right at the start of the ceremony, they have the waves rolling in. They're all lit up. And there's a moment of just reflection where it's all silent apart from the sound of the waves. And it was really quite a beautiful moment, particularly knowing that you are in the exact location where 107 years ago, Australians rowed their boats up to begin this fight at Gallipoli. It was pretty touching.
Well said, Carrie.
Special place.
Yeah, thank you.